ago. We're about to, in a couple weeks, we're shooting a follow-up video for our next single, and I'm not going to tell you what that is yet.
I think I know, but I won't tell anybody.
Okay.
I have my own prediction for it. Yeah, Leslie Zimmerman, your PR people told me a little hint. Do you have any upcoming shows?
Yeah, we're playing the Viper Room in West Hollywood. February 15th, Saturday night.
Excellent.
So it's going to be a record release party. They're going to be filming and recording the show.
Are you nervous about that one?
Nah, I don't really get nervous at shows too often anymore. I mean, we're pretty excited about it, and we expect to have our tour set up shortly after that.
Well, I think it's going to go really well. I really like the album. It resonates with me. It's got a good sound, and obviously you guys have some good people behind you, some of your creative advisors.
Oh, yeah. We have a really good team. Now the guys are really happy with everybody in the team. Everyone's doing good jobs for us.
You have some big names backing you. David Sprent and Tom Baker and Fred Archambault. That's exciting. Can I ask you, who is your main influence as far as music goes? Who would you say is your favorite band?
Influences? I mean, if you're asking me personally.
Yeah, I'm asking you personally.
Yeah, it varies, band member to band member, of course. More or less, I'm a huge Beatles fan. Also, a huge Guns N' Roses fan. Two of my favorite groups ever. The wide variety is I probably have 1,500 CDs.
Right.
And I listen to everything. Everything from like Johnny Cash to like Beethoven, like the Beatles, the Guns N' Roses, the Slayer.
Yeah, sounds like my kind of guy there. Hey, I like that. Yeah, I listen to a little bit of everything as well. If you had to narrow it down for the band, what would you say that your sound is?
I mean, overall, it's hard to pin things down. I mean, we're just a heavy rock and roll band at the end of the day, but there's a lot of like metal influences, punk rock attitude.
Yeah, I heard the punk rock attitude. I liked it.
You know, the new records, there's a little more variety of stuff going on. Being that we were able to do a full length, sorry, the sound, everything that we do.
Right. Now, do you do all of the writing, or do you guys do like a collaboration?
I mean, it depends on the song. I do a lot of writing, yeah, and everybody in the group definitely collaborates on the stuff and has their part. Everybody shifts an idea of the songs. It's a pretty good overall team, like songwriting team.
Yeah, you do. You guys have a great sound. How long have you guys been together?
About 5 years or so.
And how did you guys meet? Did you guys go to school together?
No, it's kind of a long story. I've been friends with a singer on Taco for a long time. We were in other groups, and we were friends. We would write songs on the side and hang out. When we started the group, these other two guys, Nick and Martin, that were in a band together. Initially, we brought Martin in as our bass player and started collaborating ideas with him. And then once we had everything together, we brought Nick in.
Definitely done a good job putting together a good team to make a very good sound.
Thank you. Yeah, everything's been pretty handpicked from the band members to our crew, and try to keep it a real more of a family type of vibe with the band. So.
Right. Now, I saw the video for It's Our Evolution. It's very interesting.
Thank you.
Who was behind that idea?
We shot with P.R. Brown. He's a pretty famous music director, video director.
Right.
And everything kind of stems off the lyrics and what we talked about. It's about being able to break out of your current boundaries or restrictions in life, evolve and build and move forward with whatever it is that you want to do in life and seeing beyond where you're currently at. So the videos, it came across like pretty artsy, I guess. Whoever sees the lyrics in mine will understand everything going on with it.
Right. I saw the evolution. It was definitely interesting. I liked the concept. It's fresh.
Yeah, we wanted to do something a little different, so we'll have something to talk about.
Where can people get more Living Death Bites? Where can they get your album? Can they buy it on iTunes? And is it going to be on Amazon?
Yeah, everywhere. It's got released everywhere worldwide.
Are you guys on Spotify, too?
Yeah, it's on Spotify. It's on iTunes, of course. Amazon, everywhere. I pretty much think anywhere God's green earth that you can download or steal music these days.
Darn it.
So,
we want you to get paid for that, too.
I'm feeling that too, our new record, but whatever it takes to do, we'll band up and make everything happen, so.
Right. Indeed, I hear that. Alan,
right.
Thank you so much for speaking with me and allowing me to interview you.
Yeah,
very
for
cool.
Sure, absolutely. Hey, this is Alan Damian with Living Dead Bites, and you're listening to Steph and Jen Get Real on KLAS.
And that was Alan from Living Dead Bites.
And of course, Jen has to work a regular job and couldn't be there.
Oh, she wasn't. That was sad.
Jen works during the day and it sucks.
Jen does work a regular job, indeed.
Yeah.
She's a slave to the grind.
Yeah,
what can I say?
For now.
But, we're going to play a little Living Dead Lights now just because we interviewed.
Yeehaw.
You're listening to The Living Dead Lights. This is our evolution on Steph and Jen Get Real. They have the video out, and actually, cool. It is on our website.
Go to our website.
All right, that's Living Deadlights. That is exclusive right there, guys. Total exclusive on KLAS 89.7. You heard it here first on Steph and Jen Get Real. That's right.
Literally, first interview.
Literally, first interview, first song, first everything. So, yes, that is very big. And you guys go to Spotify and check them out. Like them and follow them on Facebook and everywhere else. I put up all the links onto our website, StephandJenGetReal.com.
Thank you, Leslie Zimmerman.
Yes, thank you, Leslie Zimmerman.
Public relations person for bringing them to us.
She's always helpful to us. We love her.
Wonderful.
Yes, so we're going to do it too for Thursday on that note. And I'm going to play the other song that I really, really like off of this album. And it's called Vacant.
Oh, yeah. Very good song.
Very good song. Anyway, you guys, check them out. Living Deadlights. Steph and Jen Get Real.
Say what you want to say.
I don't have the time.
prescription's over. Say what you want to say.
Was Living Deadlights yet again. That was Vacant off of the album
Woo.
Black Letters. Yeah, go to Spotify, pick it up, you guys, or go to iTunes, pay for it. Heck yeah. Go to Spotify and pay for it too. Why not? Give fans some money. They need it. Well, they don't need it, but you know, everybody likes money. Why not?
Yeah.
Why not? Yeah. Thank you again to Leslie Zimmerman, and also Doug Goldstein is their manager. So, you know, they have some really good people behind them, like Fred Archambault from Avenged Sevenfold. Jen, one of your favorites.
I love them.
I know. And Tom Baker, he was in Nine Inch Nails, Marilyn Manson, and Rob Zombie. So, I mean, like, they have a really good sound, and jeez, they're freshies, so they have plenty of time to continue to rock, which is awesome. We like that. You are listening to Steph and Jen Get Real here, and I think I might go to Queens of the Stone Age because I feel really bad for them because of the whole Grammy incident, we all know. Anybody who saw it knows the travesty that went down.
It's just wrong.
It is kind of wrong. It's very wrong, kind of. Definitely. So I think I'm going to play another song. Queens of the Stone Age, Steph and Jen Get Real.